He has been in the saddle for nearly 3 years. Godwin Obaseki. No other testimonial before the Edo electorate in 2016, other than that he was the head of the technical team and that he was the Adams Oshomole's administration brain box. Indeed, he has more than proven on those two measures and lived up to the billing of changing the entire contour of Edo economic landscape. And this is stating the general perception, as more than a public relations staff, opponents, friends, and distant persons all to one acknowledge that Godwin Obaseki indeed is proven to be a reformer needed to make Edo State really work beyond mere infrastructure of roads, and roads. He is the technocrat he has been always touted as. Everything about his administration is methodical, due process based, and strategic. Coming from a finance background and grounded in government bureaucracy, after 8 years, he has beefed up the state's internally generated fund to twice what he meant it was at his takeoff. With increased funding at his disposal, he has deployed resources judiciously and prudently blocked leakages in the system. And hence, it was so easy to get him being called the Wake and See Governor, a sobriquet he earned for working silently at night on Edo State roads and infrastructures, only for people to wake in the morning to behold newer done-up roads, new buildings, all in the interest of the people. Over 300 new roads in 3 years in all of Edo State and an almost completed new High Court complex. The over 40 years old abandoned Secretariat building is coming alive again with a makeover. Godwin Obaseki is not just only about physical structure, he's interested in human capital development. His concept of modernizing Edo State's economy is very evident in the Edo Innovation Hub as a way to pool the energies of the youth into a digital and technological economy and thereby rewrite Edo State's future. To give more fillip to the idea, the Benin Technical College, a donation from the Canadian government in the 70s and run down over the years, is seeing a new resurgence and is now revamped and ready to provide manpower and employment for the youth, able-bodied young men and women, for whom technical and vocational education is a must in a modern Edo State. As an extension of his new vision to impact on Edo State's economy, the Gele Gele project, a seemingly unending song for years, is finally taking a dimension with a massive engineering design, which will see the project having a link with Delta State through Cocoa Port area of the Benin River. This will create a new blue economy for the contiguous states and revamp Edo State's employment and investment scene like we are yet to dream of. Then for complementarity, there are the industrial and energy parks in Obayonto and Osiomong. This is what the Americans describe as, we've got you covered. Whether to the north, east, south and west of the state, actions for development is ongoing at a frenetic pace. To merge with a drive-up of Edo State, Governor Obaseki is also seeking for investors, both at home and as far out as Dubai, where he was recently, even while on his recent and first vacation. It only shows the kind of person he is, that Edo State is ever on his mind. Accompanying the drive for external investors, he is angling for Edos in the diaspora, as is working on a housing estate project which will provide the kind of comfort and security our indigents abroad would like to come home to. And then, of course, the expatriates who will work in our midst at the new digital and technological economy would be guaranteed a commodious living space. With a surge of more persons at work in the state, with improved living standards, the traffic situation in our major urban areas would need an effective management control. Instead of the former bellicose and not so well-trained personnel, we now have a revamped Edo State Traffic Management Agency, ETSMA, a more urbane and determined agency. The total man that Governor Enogoase Obaseki is, he has a policy of no one left behind. He has revealed that in an effective and courageous approach in collaborating with local and international agencies to addressing once and for all the ugly face of Edo State in the pernicious human trafficking and irregular migration scenario. a new huge complex to house returnees is being built, with provisions to equip them with all the needed moral, confidence, social and financial support. The Edo State Song is changing. In his work in these 3 years thus far, he, the governor, has found a worthy ally and partner in Comrade Philip Shaibu, his deputy. A man ever full of smiles and a strong pillar in the administration, the deputy governor's passion and abiding love for sports has led him to reposition a former Bendel Insurance Football Club, formerly written off, in his coming to reckoning in the Super 8 League of the NFF, and today with a jersey wearing deputy governor, Comrade Philip Shaibu, who plays with the boys. The club is winning and winning, thus bringing back the glory of the old Edo State in sports. No doubt, whether you are at the sidelines or indeed in the midfield of Edo State, the consensus is that Governor Godwin Obaseki has integrity, is selfless, is a silent worker, and is competent. Well ahead of the season, endorsements are coming in ahead of the endorsement season. Why? It's a people testimony to see that there is consolidation, growth, and a new face and phase of Edo State post-2020. What is building up is too good to lose. The determination to industrialize Edo State, if given a chance to stand for re-election in 2020. These testimonials are indeed worthy endorsements for Governor Godwin Obaseki. A summary assessment of his governance performance since 2016. From President Muhammadu Buhari, Mr. Obaseki is a seasoned person. I assure you and recommend him to you so that you will continue to grow. From John Odige Oyegun, Obaseki is resourceful and intelligent. He is a software, while Oshomole is a hardware that regenerated the state into a national development yardstick. From Adams Oshomole, during the commissioning of 75 new intra-city buses, I'm humbled by your accomplishments and proud that you are fulfilling the promises you made during the 2016 electioneering campaign. You are working tirelessly to industrialize the state and make life easy for the people. And from Aliko Dangote, after over 3 decades in business, I've learned that personal integrity is as important as executive skill in business dealings. Godwin has both in abundance.